बार बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ प्रकल्प के अंतर्गत प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस के अवसर पर एक विशेष कार्यक्रम में 11 ऐसी महिलाओं को सम्मानित किया जा रहा है जिनके द्वारा बालिकाओं की शिक्षा की दिशा में विशेष योगदान दिया गया है। इन सम्मानित महिलाओं में ITU गोल्ड के चेयरमैन पद्मश्री डॉक्टर सुधीर पारीख की जीवन संगिनी डॉक्टर सुधा पारीख भी सम्मिलित हैं। पेश है उनसे वाराणसी में हुई बातचीत का ये अंश।
आई फील वेरी हम्बल्ड एंड ऑनर्ड दैट बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज रिकॉग्नाइजिंग माय वर्क एंड माय एफर्ट्स, सो आई एम वेरी प्लीज्ड एंड हैप्पी अबाउट एंड इट इज गुड दैट दे आर रिकॉग्नाइजिंग अनदर 10 persons also, so it is inspiring for other women to do the same work and do something more, and it is an inspiration for me too to do something better in future. And education is the only way to improve the life, not only for herself but entire family, because an educated woman can empower whole family, so it is very very important that women's girls education is very important, and I think we need lot of improvement, but we are on doing slowly improvement. That is a good part. We need more school, better teachers, better help to the school, better facilities, so if we provide all this to the girls and the school, so in future the women can be independent and they can be better supporter to their family. Our Prime Minister Narendra Bhai Modi, he started this Beti Bachao. Now it is spreading all over India, and I think it is going in the right direction. Only thing what we need is some more suggestion, more improvement, and more people to get involved and empower the whole program.
Madam is getting award, and how do you feel?
Well, I feel really very, humble, honored and privileged, since she is working a lot of work for women empowerment, particularly in the poorest poor area of the Gujarat. And we have 82 schools, secondary school, mainly meant for children, female, is a girl schools, and whole idea is to have those girl school, because the girl they have facility of the sanitation and everything, so they can come to the school, get the hot meal, plus they are not afraid of or concerned about the sanitation and toilet and all those things, and that way these women can more educated, and then by doing that we are empowering indirectly whole family through our NGO called Global Life, where our main motto is this elementary schools, secondary schools, and empower women for cottage industry, so they can the women, those who are not educated, they can learn something to sustain family themselves,
like the government is going on same right direction.
I think government is going definitely in the right direction, and the fact that this year this Beti Bachao Beti Sikhao Foundation program is one of the main event of this Pravasi Bharatiya conference, that shows that government's priority is really well placed, and we really thank you Prime Minister Modi's government for giving priority to women's empowerment, and I'm sure we all NRIs will do our bit to help women's empowerment in India.
How do you feel like you are in America and you are working for here for Gujarat and Indian villages?
Well, I feel really very proud and satisfied, because I always believe that more you give, more you become. And when we were young and in the college or school, most of even medical school, our education was 80% subsidized by government of India. So what we are today in USA is because of motherland. So it's our duty to give back to motherland whichever one can.
पद्मश्री डॉक्टर सुधीर पारिक पिछले 15 वर्षों से हर प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस में सम्मिलित होते रहे हैं। उन्हें 2006 में प्रवासी भारतीय दिवस पर सम्मानित भी किया गया था।
आई एम अटेंडिंग ऑल 15 प्रवासी भारतीय कॉन्फ्रेंसेस सिंस 2003 एंड आई वाज वन ऑफ द अवॉर्डी इन प्रवासी भारतीय सम्मान अवॉर्डी इन 2006 फॉर माय रिलेंटलेस वर्क फॉर यूएस इंडिया रिलेशन where I was instrumental or driving force creating India Caucus in US Congress. And every year Pravasi Bharatiya Divas is getting better and better because I think Prime Minister Modi has a special affinity for NRIs and he's giving a very dynamic priority to the NRIs and their issues and concern. And I would always urge NRIs to be part of it because this is a great networking platform, not only for helping the government or helping the India, but it's also for commercial, economical and social and political point of view. And today's this PBD is, I think, the largest so far in last 15 PBD. I think there are, I understand that over 5,000 delegates are registered here. And that shows, and particularly in the city like Varanasi, which is, as you know, is the oldest city, even older than Babylon. So that shows our culture, heritage, and our love for Mother India and culture of India.
Dr. Pari ke anusar, NRI Day विभिन्न NRIs को मिलने जुलने का एक दुर्लभ अवसर प्रदान करता है. भारत सरकार की प्राथमिकताओं की सराहना करते हुए, उन्होंने ये सुझाव भी दिया कि सरकार द्वारा एक नोडल एजेंसी की स्थापना की जानी चाहिए।
There should be a nodal agency by the government, and they should screen out or they should advise investor who are the credible people here, partners in a business or who are not credible. And because a lot of NRIs are in the past, they burnt out or they got kind of short-handed, cheated by a lot of local. Indian agents, those who are not very, those who are unscrupulous, let's put it that way. So I think if there is a nodal agency, then we can check and reference that, okay, so-and-so, Mr. XYZ, what is their background, what is their past history in the business, and what is their credit worthiness. I think that's very important for business part perspective.